Let's worship him for a few moments. Come on, let's worship him for a few moments, for he is so worthy to be magnified and lifted up. Come on, somebody, give God some glory. King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody lift those hands right now and give God some praise this morning, for he alone is so worthy. Hallelujah, Jesus. We love you, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord Jesus. Father, we love you. Come on, come on, we're the worshipers. Even in your home, come on, somebody give God some worship. Worship him just because he's God. Worship him just because he is God. Just because praise. Do we have a just because praise this morning? Lord, we love you. Somebody say, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, we love you today. Lord, we love you. We honor your holy name. The presence of God is in this place. The presence of God is in your living room. Wherever you may be, the presence of God is with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody worship him for a few moments. Just forget about your circumstances. Forget about your situation. Forget about what they are saying and give God some praise. Come on, just release your praise in this place. Release your praise in this place. Release the worship unto the living King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is God. Somebody give him some praise, for he is so worthy. He's so worthy, 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 worthy. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. There's deliverance in your praise. There's breakthrough in your praise. Hallelujah. There's healing in your praise. Come on, somebody. Push, 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 push. There's deliverance in your praise. Somebody give God some praise. Yeah. Praise him. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, somebody. There it is. There's deliverance in your praise. Somebody need to hear some praise. When the praise is coming, they say, send Judah first. Do I have any praises in the house? Somebody give them praise. Yeah, yeah. Praise them, praise them. Come on, come on, come on. I see the chains falling off. I remember Paul and Silas. At midnight, they begin to praise. And the shackles were loose. The jail, hello, everybody in the jail heard them. Hello, somebody. It was in the praise. Come on, somebody. Your family members need to be loose right now. Come on, do I have any believers in the house? Praise him. Praise him. Come on, somebody. The son and daughter's coming home. The prodigal son is already home. Come on, somebody. The husband, the wife is being saved right now. Come on, somebody. Give them a praise. Oh, come on, COVID-19 can't stand your praise. Sugar diabetes can't stand your praise. Cancer can't stand your praise. Do I have any believers in the house? Come on, somebody. Come on, release your praise. Release your praise. Release your praise. Release your praise. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Somebody's getting a financial breakthrough in their praise. I don't care what you've been going through. Somebody give them praise. Sickness is falling off of you. Come on, believers. Come on, come on. Somebody push. The devil is still a liar. He's been a liar since the beginning. Our God reigns. Somebody say, he reigns. 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 Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah. Somebody say, our God reigns. Come on, somebody say it. Our God reigns. Come on, somebody. Our God reigns. Yes, he is. Our God reigns. Yes, he does. Come on. Our God reigns. In your living room, on your job, in your home. Our God reigns forever. Somebody say, he reigns. Our God reigns. Come on, somebody say he reigns. Our God reigns. Come on, somebody give him praise. Our God reigns. Glory, 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 glory. Yes, he reigns. Yes, he reigns. Yes, he reigns. Somebody say he reigns. Yes, he reigns. He reigns over COVID-19. He reigns over cancer, sugar, diabetes, HIV and AIDS. It doesn't matter. He reigns. He's still ruling. Hello, somebody. Our God reigns. Our God reigns. Yes, he does. Our God reigns. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, the peace of God is in this place. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. The peace of God is in this place. Daddy God, in the name of Jesus, we speak. You are still in control. And Father, even as I stand before your people today, God, I ask that you move by your spirit. I decrease and you decrease. That way you, God, may get the glory. Not me, God, that you get the glory in this place. I decree it right now in the name of Jesus. Everything, 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 nothing missing, nothing lacking, nothing broken. Today is the day. The chains are being broken. I decree it to be so. Today is the day. Your son and daughter shall be saved. I decree it right now. Sick bodies shall be healed. In the name of Jesus. I decree right now in the name of Jesus. It is finished. And those that hear me today say it is finished in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody give them praise. Come on, give them praise. Give them praise right there in your living room. Come on, do somebody have a radical praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, the peace of God is in this place. Oh, the peace of God. The peace of God. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. The peace of God is in this place. My, 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 my. Glory, 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 glory. Hey, glory, glory, glory. How God reigns. How God reigns. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, the Spirit of God is in this place. Oh, the worship. The Spirit of God is in this building. The Spirit of God is in your home. Children, this is youth service, youth Sunday that we call it, but our God reigns. Just worship him, just worship him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I refuse to wait until the battle is over to shout. Hallelujah, release your praise, release your worship. Oh glory, there's deliverance in this atmosphere, even in your home, there's deliverance. There's deliverance is taking place right now, sons and daughters. Oh God, everything is well. Everything is well. All is well. I decree it to be so. All is well. I decree it to be so. All is well. Release. Release your praise. Release your praise. Release your praise. Release your praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Give God a hand clap of praise if you can. Hallelujah. He's moving. He's moving. Even in your home, wherever you may be, he's moving. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God for his presence today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's okay to cry. It's okay. Oh, the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We decree that today. Yeah, we say yes. We say yes. Would you tell him yes today? Yeah, 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 yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. My God. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Give it honor to Daddy God, our Lord and our Savior. Thank God for the set men of this house, Apostle Shelton and Prophetess Nadine. We want to honor them in the name of Jesus today. Amen. Hallelujah. I don't plan on being before you long. I just want to encourage the believers, our children of God, the youth. I want you to understand and know that God is still in control. Doesn't matter how I look. Today I want to just encourage and remind every believer that God is still in control even now. We have to learn to speak that over ourselves. Speak over our lives. I also want to compel those that don't know Jesus, those that are lost, to come in, those that don't know what to do, to reach out. Because I know a Savior, my God, that's bigger than our federal government. As you see, our government can't help us, but God. Amen. You may take your seats if you're standing, if you have, you want to sit now. Hallelujah. And if I had to give a title for this today, it would be God is our refuge and strength even now. That means doesn't matter what's going on, God is still God even now. And I'm going to cover that. If you look across the country right now, there's so much going on. There's so much uncertainty. People in fear, they're worrying. They don't know what's going to happen with our economy. People have lost their jobs. People, hours are being cut. Children can't go back to school, or some are going back to school. There's uncertainty. They're having to quarantine. There's so much going on in this world that we live in, not just in the United States, but in the world as a whole. And everyone is waiting and depending, well, most people are waiting and depending on the government. But what I come to tell you this morning, that God is your refuge and strength, even now. So don't get caught up on waiting on someone who's not your Savior. But a lot of people are waiting on that. People are losing jobs as well. Places are shutting down. But understand this, even the federal government don't even have an answer for COVID. Now, we honor those that are fighting diligently to find a cure. But how many know that the only keeper we have is Jesus? It doesn't matter where you go, and the profession that I do, I know I've been around people that may have been affected, but God. You got to understand, it's not the mask. It's not the, and that's fine. We do what they tell us to do, but at the end of the day, it is God that does the calling. Do I have any believers in the house? Doesn't matter what's going on. And we got COVID-19. We have injustice. I said, why is that? That's because there's an absence of God. Anytime you have an absence of God, there will always be chaos. Look around us. People still killing folks in spite of this pandemic. Folks still robbing, stealing, you name it. They're doing all of that in spite of everything that they see in the natural realm. But I've come to tell you today, God is your refuge. Even now. Now, we got the political arena, and I tell people that I'm not into politics at all. I'm into Jesus. How about that? Because at the end of the day, it's not the Democrat, it's not the Republican, it's not the independent party, it is Christ Jesus. Because they're fighting instead of looking for a solution. And there's only one solution. And that's Jesus. But what has happened is it's what we call a sidebar or a distraction. So the Democrats fighting the Republicans, but nobody's talking about Jesus. But the true refuge we have in strength is Christ. Now, even we watch some of these debates on Zoom, however they're doing them now. But I'll tell you this. They always say, let's fact check the politician or the experts. But as a believer, we have to truth check the facts. Now, everything I just said to you may be the truth. You see it. But as a believer, I'm going to give you a scripture. We're going to go to Psalms 46. And I'm going to move around a little bit. But I'm here today to, I just gave you a bunch of world facts. Now, that's the truth now. This is what's going on. COVID-19 is real. Coronavirus is real. But guess what? Who's eternal? Who's real? Jesus. Come on, somebody. So I'm not going to stand here and give it praise. I'm here to give God some praise. Do I have any believers in the house? Psalms 46. Now, see, now you've heard the facts of life. Let me clear this up. You've heard the facts of life. But every believer needs to truth check those facts. Psalms 46, 1 and 3. It says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters therefore war and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. Now I'm going to go down to verse 10. I'm going to skip to verse 10. It's 46. It says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Verse 11 says, the Lord of hosts is with us. Somebody say, the Lord of hosts is with me. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Tell your neighbor, even now. See, now I got to have something to back that up. People are saying, well, even now, how can you say that? Let me just define the word refuge for those that don't know. It means shelter or protection from danger or in distress. Let me pause there. There's, I think, two storms out there on the ocean. You need some refuge. My God. When it's, you ain't going to stand outside. It's not a cat one, cat two. No, you ain't. You need some refuge. You need some protection. You need shelter. Do I have any believers? It also means a place that provides shelter or protection. Something to which one has recourse in difficulties. You mean, so if it's raining outside right now, I'm in here so I'm covered. Hello, somebody. So now if it's storming outside, I don't have to stay out there and get wet. You don't have to stay outside and get wet. You can come inside. Now, I'm going to look at the word strength. It says the quality or state of being strong, capacity for exertion or endurance, power to resist force, strength. Come on, somebody. Legal, logical, moral force, a strong attribute or inherent asset, degree or potency of effective or concentration. So you got to have strength. Hello, somebody. And also the word even now. It says, or and then. It says now or then as well as before. What? What you say? Even now. Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, we know it's crazy. For my youth, it's crazy out there, ain't it? But even now. Now, I often used to say when I used to our history books in school, I would say, man, I couldn't have been back then doing slavery. God knew that. That's why I'm here now. Do I have any believers in the house? See, I used to say that. I would have been there to kill me. I would have been the first one dead because I'm not going for that. But see, we often say that because I read when I was in school, I was like, they did what? They made them do what? They ate what? They did what? Yes, master. No, we're not doing that. But God knew that because he's God. So he said, I'm going to place you here right now. Even now. So now that's an you have no excuse, believers. Trying to figure out, God, why am I going through this? God has placed you here for such a time as this, even now. Hello, somebody. And I'm about to run. So let me hurry up and move. I'm almost done here. Y'all don't understand something. See, we are without excuse. Because we used to say, how many used to say? Come on, somebody. All of us have a used to say. What had happened? Come on, somebody. Yeah, I know that's not proper, but I'm just messing with y'all this morning because I want y'all to get it. I couldn't have been there. That couldn't have been me. God said, I placed you here for such a time as this. Hello, somebody. And also, even now, also mean in spite of what has happened. Even now, I mean in spite of what has happened. At this very moment, believers, those that are watching, at this very moment, you're on your job for this very moment. You're in your neighborhood for this very moment. You can't go to school, children, whatever. You're there for such a time as this. And God is still a refuge and strength even now. Do I have any believers in the house? Now look. I know when you're looking at social media, when you're looking at the news, when you're looking at all that stuff and what they're saying, it'll make you crazy if you keep watching it, and it puts fear and doubt. But I want you to understand that there is nothing happening unless Daddy God allows it. Now, somebody said, well, that's that in the Bible. You mean Jesus did this? I didn't say Jesus, God did this. But understand, if it's not God sent, it will be God used. Where is that in the Bible? I am glad you asked me that. We're going to go to Genesis 50. Because I'm going to have to back up what I'm saying here. Hello, somebody. See, this is truth. You're saying, well, how you what you mean? God sent the corona. I didn't say that. Don't quote that. I did not say that. I hope recording, so I didn't say that. But I'm telling you, believer, whatever it is that you're going through, it may not be daddy God sent. I like to call it, it's personal for me. But it will be daddy God used if you can just be still and know. My God. Now, Genesis 50, 19 and 20 says, and Joseph said unto them, talking to his brothers, fear not, for I am in the place of God. What are you saying there? God is the judge. My God. But as for you, ye thought evil against me. But God meant it unto good to bring to pass as this day to save much people alive. Now, can I just paraphrase here, and to those that are theologians or whatever you want to call yourself, can I just paraphrase today? See, Joseph's father had died. And now, see, the brothers, y'all know the brothers sold him, had unsold him into slavery. They push him in the pit first. So they thinking, well, hey, man, daddy dead. He going to get us. But I want you to understand something. See, he was in Potiphar's house and giving control everywhere that he went in the midst of what they thought was evil. It was evil. Hello, somebody. But Joseph, the Bible says that the Lord was with Joseph. Even now. Somebody in this building, can you say even now? So no, mind you, you know, they lied. And then you got Potiphar's wife. You know, everywhere he went to prison, they gave him the keys. I wish somebody would give me the keys if I was locked up. That's what they said. Amen. But because God was with him. Now, she lied on him because he didn't want to sleep with her. Got him in prison. Now, mind you, he said, yeah, I done been to prison. Joseph telling him, bro, look here, I done been to prison. I'm paraphrasing. I've been to prison. I've been falsely accused, and I didn't even do it. But see, what happened, even in the midst of prison, there was a chief baker and butler. And it's the same thing that made his brothers dislike him was the fact that he was an old dreamer and he wasn't telling the dream. Hello, somebody. See, sometimes the very thing that you think got you jacked up and messed up will be the very thing God used to deliver you. So somebody said, I need to be myself because everybody else is taken. Do I have any believers in the house? So now, mind you, he's saying, look here, bro. Y'all brothers, y'all put me in here. Y'all did me like that. But I was in the prison. I think they put him in the innermost part of the prison. See, he wasn't even in regular prison. He had to look up. Prison was up. He was down. Come on, somebody. So it don't matter where you're at. So he's saying, look, y'all don't understand. I'm down here in the dungeon like I hear back there. Rats, roaches, you name it. All this stuff. And these brothers had a dream. And I interpret the dream. My God, my God. And the baker guy, he was killed. But the butler, he was restored. Now, see, what I did, this is, I'm paraphrasing, I'm just, what I did is I tried to help daddy God out. I said, hey, breaker, look here, man. Please tell him I ain't got no business down here. I didn't do anything. Listen, man, I'm innocent. The woman took my coat. But the woman took my coat. But I got another thing for the brothers. He was too close. But we ain't going to go there today. But she took my coat. So tell him I didn't sleep with his wife. It wasn't me. Hello, somebody. So he trying to get out on his own. He says, remind him, please tell him. The baker gets up. He goes, hey, he been released. He got his bag. He getting released. So I was dying. I'm being Joseph, y'all. And I'm paraphrasing. Joseph's dying there saying, you know, hey. Yeah, that brother going, yeah, I got that dream. He been restored. I know I'm getting out of here. God made it so that he didn't remember. Understand something. That's because, see, let me say this. If he had a got out then, God knew that he had myself, and I still on the inside of him. See, that cost him two more years. Somebody said, when, Lord, when, Lord, when? The fact that you're still asking when, you still need a savior in that situation because you're stuck on the when, the how, and the why. So back to, he says, I waited two more years, man. He didn't remember me. I done told his brother that he going to be restored, and he been 2 years.
But now, my God, was it Potiphar that had that dream? Or wanted to get that dream? And guess what? God put Joseph in his Pharaoh. Pharaoh had that dream. And he put him in his mind. The same person, hello somebody, the same baker. Pharaoh had the dream. Thank you for the correction. Pharaoh had the dream, and the same person that he said, hey, listen, tell him I'm innocent, man. God made it so he would not remember. But he said, I know a man that's in prison, and he can tell you what your dream means. Now, all of his little cohorts, all of his people, all his posse, whatever you want to call them, all of his so-called men of God, his army, could not interpret the dream. So the baker said, wait a minute, hold everything. I know somebody. And he said, go get him. My God. But see, I want y'all to catch this. When he realized that, Joseph got out. He said, Pharaoh said, well, I hear that you, I want y'all to catch this, you can interpret. Now, those 2 years were very critical. The time that you are waiting even now is very critical because it determines when God moves for you. He said, it is not in me. That's exactly what Joseph said. It is not in me. And you know the story. And what he said to his brothers, say, listen, brothers, if I can paraphrase, he said, brothers, if y'all wouldn't have never put me in that pit, if you would have never did what you did to me, you wouldn't be standing here today because there was a famine in the land and I was able to bring y'all in. So no matter where you are, hello somebody, what's going on in your life, do not despise that because God is still in control. Do I have any believers in there? Understand something, that God is so strategic. So now, did I not just tell y'all the truth in God's word? That it don't have to be God sent to push you in a pit, but it will be God used if you can just trust Daddy God. Do I have any believers in the house? Now, again, let me go back and say this. Man of God, child, man of God, if Mordecai wouldn't have been at the gate, if Esther wouldn't have been in the palace, come on, somebody. God has placed you here strategically. So now it's what you do with the placement that God is watching. So you can't go to school, children, and you can't go to work properly. You have the social. God is watching how you pivot and how you move. Because Mordecai stayed at the gate. So, man of God, you got to stay on post. You have to keep, hello somebody, what God is having you to do. You have to keep hold to God. Woman of God, if you're in the palace, God has placed you there for such a time as this. And I wanted to say to you believers, don't worry about your Hamans. Those that are trying to kill, steal, and destroy. Those that are lying on you. Because, you know, those Hamans will hang themselves, just like Judas's will. So don't get caught up on that. Let me give you some more scriptures. They say, he just talking, he ain't got no scripture. Let me shut y'all down in Jesus' name. Amen, believers. Let's go to Colossians 1, 6 and 18, through 18, I'm sorry. Now, this covers, well, y'all don't know. These people got everything. They got all this, they got all that. Listen, the word says, for by him were all things created. I'm sorry, 16, chapter 1, verse 16, amen, through 18. Colossians 1, 16 through 18 says, for by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether there be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things are created by him and for him. 17 says, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn, from the dead, that in all things he might have preeminence. Some are saying, I can't see an end to this COVID-19. The problem is you're trying to see. Now, see, you're trying to see with these eyes. But understand something. The word of God says in 2 Corinthians 5, 4, we walk by faith and not by sight. You may not be able to see the end of a thing, but I know the end of the story. Tell your neighbor, we win. According to the word, we have already won. Do I have any believers in the house? So you trying to see your way out of COVID or whatever you may be going through. God said, you're looking with the wrong eyes. Look into the mirror of my word. Because the word says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. That was Hebrews 11 and 1. Hebrews 11 and 6 says, but without faith it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. My God. So that means I got to stop looking at these. I'm not saying be blind and you can't drive like that. You'll have an accident. Now, that's a disclaimer. So he told me to don't be looking. No, you better look while you drive. Some things that we're responsible. I'm talking about spiritually. You're trying to see. I don't see my way out. Stop trying to look and ask God. Do I have any believers in the house? Now, I'm going to go to Romans 8:24. Romans chapter 8, starting at verse 24. And everybody loves to say this and walk, try to walk in this. No, they just talking it. And the word of the Lord says, for we are saved by hope. But hope that is seen is not hope. Hold everything. So you saying, if I see it, I don't need to open. Duh. I hope I can get me a rag. Hello? It's right here. Okay? But it says, for what man seeth, why do he yet hope for it? Makes no sense. Amen? 25 says, but if we hope for that which is not seen, then do we patiently wait for it? My God. So those that are waiting to go back to school, to those that are waiting for their job to open up, to those that are waiting for whatever it is that they're waiting for, God has said, are you waiting patiently? Are you allowing Daddy God to move? Or are you doing like Joseph did when he told the baker to remember him? Is he delaying his stay? Do I have any believers? 26 says, likewise. See, when you wait, y'all got to understand, when you patiently wait, not when you try to brown nose or come up another way, when you patiently wait, catch this. It says, 26 says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. So he sees you patiently waiting. He sees you've been passed up. He sees you trying to come up. He said, it says, helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit, that's a capital S, the Spirit of the living God, itself making intercessions for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. So you mean to tell me if I patiently wait, Daddy God steps in, Holy Spirit steps in, and I'm patiently waiting and working as unto the Lord. I'm not getting weary in my well-doing. I'm waiting on him. That's when Holy Spirit comes in. My God, when you're waiting on your son and your daughter, your husband, your wife, whatever it is to be saved, set free, and delivered, you don't have to just beat them every time you see them. Hello, somebody. If you can just wait, Daddy God begin to move. Hello, somebody. But you got to live so. Do I have any believers? Verse 27 says, and he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And the verse 28, everybody will say, and we know that all things work together for the good of them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. And I added an end, period, even now. But it's not the things that are working. It's Daddy God that's working. See, people think things, money becomes things. No. That's not what's working. It's Daddy God using the environment to help you out. Come on, somebody. See, Paul and Silas used their praise. Hello, somebody. It wasn't in their singing. It's because they had God on the inside. Do I have any believers in the house today? Believer, it doesn't matter what you are going through or what you think is dead. I want you to know that God's will prevail. If you don't see it, you just believe it. Come on, somebody. Do I have an ability? Can I talk to you just for a few moments as I'm beginning to close about Daddy God? Jesus, Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. Let me cover that thing that says, well, you don't know how long I've been waiting. You don't know long how I've been. Nothing's moving. Nothing's happening. But can we just talk a little bit about Jesus, Martha, and Mary, and Lazarus? That'll be in John 11, and I'm going to move it. But you understand something. John 11, 21 says, then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother, talking about Lazarus, would have not died. But see, you probably say, where did he get even now from? Verse 22 of John 11, 11, verse 22 said, but I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give to thee. Hello, somebody. See, so mind you, he's been dead now 4 days. When they told Jesus that he was dead, Jesus, okay, I got this. Because what Jesus has to do, he's had to allow Daddy God to get the glory. See, you have to learn how to let God get the glory, even though your friends and family don't even know your story. It's not about your story. It's about his story. His story. Jesus' story. We always say history, but it's his story. Y'all get that, amen? So now, verse 23 says, and Jesus said unto her, hello, somebody. You got to understand something. He's going to live. I got this. Now, they done had the funeral, y'all. 4 days, they had the funeral. They had a funeral for him. He was dead. She even told him, say, he stank. God told him to move, roll away the stone. There's a stone in your life that God wants you to roll away, but you too busy trying to tell Daddy God, Lord, you don't know. God saying, I know, but I need you to roll away the stone so that what you think is dead, I can bring it back. Come on, somebody. So you have to understand God has placed you here for such a time as this. Now I'm going to go to 11 and 38. Jesus is therefore again groaning himself coming to the grave. We talked about, and the stone's laying on it. So you got a stone, whatever your stone, maybe your son, your daughter, your job. I don't know. That's between you and Daddy God. But God says, I need you to move it. I know he's been dead 4 days. I know he stank. I'm cash your care. I like to get into mess when you give it to me. See, you got to give it to me. See, now, mind you, when all that happened, you know the story that Jesus said, Lazarus, he had to call it by name. So you got to call that thing by name and stop claiming sugar diabetes. Stop claiming all these things that don't belong to you. According to my word, that doesn't belong to us. Hello, somebody. See, my sugar diet, devil is a lie. Next time somebody says, hold everything. Let me help you. Truth. Check that fact with the word of God. He said, by his stripes, we're healed. So what I want you to see is he's saying that no matter what's been happening, what's going on, yeah, I know it's been 400 years. I've been waiting a long time. Have you been waiting patiently so Daddy God can move? You must understand, doesn't matter what's going on, believers, God has you covered. And when he told him to remove the stone, God told him, Lazarus, come forth and take those grave clothes off of him, y'all. Now, mind you, Jesus had them to roll away the stone because that stone was unbelief. Ah, glory, glory. Y'all got to get to see that stone represents unbelief, and he smelleth. That represents unbelief. So you saying that I'm the creator. Daddy God has sent me Jesus here, and I'm worried about a stench. The only stench Jesus is worried about is the stench of sin. So that's the only stench he's worried about. So God can clean you up no matter where you are right now. He just needs you to move unbelief, roll unbelief out the way. And then once he rolls it out the way and you come out alive, God said, I want you to unravel those clothes. Take those garments off. Take all that stuff that had you bound off. Take it off. Take it off. Do I have any believers today? I just come to tell you today, believers, that it is not in what you do and what you say, is who you believe. God is trying to get us beyond this point. He wants us to realize that he is our refuge and our strength, even now. So you ought to leave this place, or you're sitting in your living room, wherever you are, whatever you may be doing. I'm here to declare and decree that God is your refuge. He has you covered. You just got to submit to him, son, daughter. It does not matter. You have to understand that these administrations on this earth, we've had many presidents. We've had many. There's going to be another administration after this. Even after when you are dead and gone and I'm dead and gone with Daddy God. But the word of God never changes. It's been here when your grandmother, mama, you know it, generations to come. The only thing that's going to be standing is the word of God. And we have to be in the ark of safety, which is the secret place of the Most High God. And you can stand to your feet. We're going to pray now that you understand and that you know. Doesn't matter what's going on. God is our refuge and strength even now. Yes. Hallelujah. We definitely need you. Oh, come on, somebody.
We need you, Lord.
Father, bless you.
We need you,
we bless
Lord.
Your name, Jesus. We decree and declare right now, we need you, Lord Jesus.
We
come on, somebody,
you,
enter into worship right now.
We need
somebody,
you,
give
Lord,
God just some worship.
Right,
we must worship him in spirit and in truth.
We lift our hands.
The spirit
and bow our knees.
Freedom is in the house. Peace.
And worship at your throne. We need you, Lord. We need you right now.
We need you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We need you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's right. That's okay. That's all right. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Somebody declare it right now in your living room where we are. Lift those hands. Hallelujah. I see he wants our worship. Yes. Yes, right now, Jesus. Hallelujah. Not our federal government, but we need you, Lord Jesus. Come on, the Spirit of God is in this place. He's in your home. He's in your living room, wherever you may be. Tell him, Lord, I need you. I need you, King Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, worship him. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I decree and declare right now, in the name of Jesus, no one else will be lost. I decree and declare right now, the backslider shall be reclaimed, set free, and delivered. Sons and daughters shall be saved. The prodigal son shall come home. I decree it right now. They'll come running to you, Daddy God. I decree right now, those that are sick and diseased will be healed in the name of Jesus. Right now, God, we surrender everything, God. We say, forgive us for our unbelief, God. Forgive us for trusting in the federal government and local governments when they're fighting, God, that we want to trust in you, who's our keeper, who's our Lord, our shepherd. God, we thank you right now. We decree and declare that all is well in the name of Jesus. Sickness and disease can't hold us. Can't hold us any longer. I decree it right now in the name of Jesus. And I decree right now, anyone watching, anyone hearing right now, later or now, it doesn't even now, that you'll never be the same as you submit yourself to Daddy God. If you don't know Jesus and a part of your sin, just say, Lord Jesus, forgive me of my sin. Accept him as your Christ right now in the name of Jesus. Surrender everything to him. I decree it to be so right now. And in the name of Jesus, all is well. Tell your neighbor, tell your family. Tell your friend, all is well in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I need you, Lord. Stand with me and say, I need you, Lord. Right now, wherever you are, stand and sing this.
Somebody worship.
need you, Lord. I need you, Lord, right now. I lift my hands and bow my knees and worship at your feet.
Come on, somebody worship him.
I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord, right now.
Somebody say it. Come on, somebody.
I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord, right now.
Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody.
I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord, right now.
Come on, somebody say, I need you, Lord.
I lift my hands and bow my knees.
Come on, somebody worship him. Hey, glory.
I need you, Lord.
Come on. Somebody say, I need you.
I need you, Lord.
Come on.
What a powerful message. Amen. What a powerful word of God. Glory be to God for the truth that was spoken. The word of the Lord says this in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 13. And I believe it sums up what Minister Vance have preached. It says, we have in the same spirit of faith according as it is written, I believed, and therefore have I spoken. And we also believe, and therefore we speak. Did y'all hear what the verse says? It says, because we have the same spirit of faith, whatever is written, we believe it, and therefore we speak. We have the same faith. So we speak the same thing. We don't go by our feelings. We don't go by news. We don't go by anything external. We go by what has already been decreed and what has already been declared. We speak what God have already said. Every question he raised, he backed it up with truth check from the word of God. And that's what you and I must do. We even have to take our own emotions. We even have to take our feelings that change every day and weigh it against this word. That number changes. So I pray you've been blessed and strengthened from the word of God, from the ministry of the word. We thank God for Minister Vance. Amen. We thank God for him being, amen, faithful over God's word. Amen. I want to thank God for Sister Arlita this morning. Open up our service. She did a beautiful job. Amen. Let's thank God for this morning. Amen. Let's thank God for our youth praise and worship team this morning. Amen. Amen. Thank God for our musicians this morning. Amen. Amen. And thank God for our media services team. I thank God for them this morning. Amen. 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 We apologize for all technical difficulties. They are out of our control. Amen. So we definitely have to call our provider and find out what's going on. Amen. Ever since the storm, we've been having some glitches in the system. So we'll get it worked out. But it in no way took away from the Spirit of God. Amen. It didn't take away from the word and take away from the worship. Amen. I'm encouraged. Amen. I'm encouraged because we have heard from God and we have been in the presence of God. Amen. And it's so good to see y'all. This is just confirmation that it's time to come on back in here. That's all it is. Amen. It's just confirmation. Amen. I was 90% sure. I'm like, I'm 100% sure. Amen. That is time. Amen. It's so good to see you all. Amen. So we just thank God for you all. Amen. I'm going to give a closing benediction. Amen. Then I want to do some acknowledgments after, amen, after the recording is also, amen. So let's just lift our hands unto the Lord. And Lord, and we just declare grace, mercy and peace over your people and all of the saints of God, those who are watching and those who will be able to watch this broadcast and this ministry later on this afternoon. We just thank you, Father God, for all that we have heard, all that we have received, and all that has been given to us by the Spirit of God. And Lord, and we thank you for truth checking every report that will come up in our lives, that we will put it and weigh it against your word, the word of God. It is already written, so therefore we believe and therefore we speak. And we give you praise, honor, and glory in the matchless name of Jesus. And all of God's people said, amen and amen, amen. God bless you.